will inform you that I'm a bit of a germaphobe, and it is quite possible a number of you may have infectious diseases. So, B will be out in just a moment. They like a little suspenseful build-up before their appearances. B, your audience is here. Oh, right. I know how they like to be introduced. This will just take a moment.
Just a waste of an audience. Why, an insult to you all if I were to just walk in the room.
Is today the day to run your fraudulent erotic phone line?
My sexy side hustles, yes, yes. B is going to be working for their pearls today. But luckily for you all, I'm a slut for an audience. So stay, make yourself comfortable. Observe the mastery, if you will. Oh, I suppose I'm getting ahead of myself. My name is B, and it's a pleasure to meet each and every one of you beautiful bastards. Oh, especially you. Hello. Anyways, I was introducing myself. Everybody keeps asking me, B, what does B stand for? What's your real name? Well, on stage they call me Bitch Boy. Yes, Bitch Boy, take it in, internalize it. Some people call me he, some people call me she, some people call me they, some people call me it. I call this hot little sex deviant production B. A certain few people call me baby, but those people pay me a lot of money. They're about to, anyways. Hi there, Big Daddy. What can B do for you, Big Daddy? Yeah, you like that? What are you doing? Ooh, you wanna know what I'm doing? Set a telepay, baby, then we'll get to the good stuff. You don't know what telepay is. It's how you pay me for what I'm doing. No, no PayPal, it's easy. Look, I'm not a telepay representative. I'm a hot, sexy little baby. Just Google it. No, you can't just drop it off. 500 an hour for starters. Hello?
How did it go?
It was a challenge. But a challenge is what I crave. And just warming up is all. Anyways, I was introducing myself. Everybody keeps asking me, B, are you a girl? Are you a boy? What were you born as? Are you some sort of queer? What are you? Well, my answer, of course, my loves, is as following. One, I am obviously very queer. And two, yes, no, no, yes. Both, neither. Andy Samberg and Britney JT threesome. And slash A, all of the above. How dare you? Thanks for asking and pay me a fat hundo and I can be whatever you like. Hi there. This is B speaking. You got my attention. Well, I'm a twonky sugar bitch looking for a sugar daddy, but even a high fructose corn syrup daddy or Splenda Papa would do. You don't know a twonk. Look, I'm not a dictionary. If you were calling a phone sex line, you should be prepared to use sex lingo. No, I didn't make those words up. Go look at Urban Dictionary so we can get ready to D-Town boogie crank our fret inks. What is this, amateur hour? I haven't stopped any true intellectuals.
I suggested a website instead of writing your phone number on a Walmart bathroom stall. The caliber of clientele.
Sweeping, it's tradition. And whom I argue with tradition.
My apologies. Conversations?
I know. But you buy the groceries. I can't take any money from you. And you're too important to me. This guy. Everybody keeps asking me. B, is Conrad your boyfriend, your husband, your significant other? No, of course not. I mean, do you see him? The epitome of straight and narrow. Can't you guys just live in the same house, call each other pet names, sleep in two separate identical beds, I Love Lucy style, and be bestest buds? Can you imagine him and me together, us together as a couple, him and me? Oh, darling, that reminds me. How was work?
Satisfactory. Two successful surgeries in the car. I ate a muffin of noteworthy quality.
Fantastic.
And thank you for dropping by to visit.
It was my pleasure.
You know you can come and visit me without having to feign an injury.
Hi, this is Bea speaking. You've come to the right place. Like come with a U. Get it? Watch Kel and all that. How about, can you all just look away from the stage for a second? Yes, that's it. If you would all just look away from the stage. Yes, I'm talking to you. Come on now. I know I'm captivating, but please, you do it for Dora. Help me out. I told you. Welcome to B-Town, population sex! God damn it! Ah!
Why did you hang up?
I did it backwards. I was overthinking it. Welcome to Sex Town, population B. Welcome to Sex Town, population B. I'm just gonna let them talk first. Fake nails on you, dearest? Big sparkly ones that stick on gems at the end?
No, B, that's against dress code. I can't perform surgery on cadavers with anything that might puncture the gloves. I'm sure you know this.
I know.
If I can take you off before Friday.
Yes. This is he, she. idea what you're talking about. I am not making money via unsolicited business practices. No, I am not conducting a side business on this phone line. I know that was in the contract, Mr. Landlord. If I were, I would answer the phone with some sort of ridiculously sexy phrase. Yes, I am a gay, but that doesn't mean you should assume anything about my character. Now, if you'll excuse me, my tofu casserole is starting to overcook, and if you know me, you know how much pride I take in perfecting my gourmet crock-pot vegan meals from Good Vegan Christian Housewife Weekly! Good God-given day to you, sir! That was a sign to continue if I ever heard one. This is our little secret, right? All 50 of you sworn to secrecy. Lovely.
Yes, Pete.
Does this bother you at all?
You talking on the phone for money, or the fact that you're speaking while I'm reading?
First one.
Not at all to both.
See? This is how you be supportive of someone. There's no jealousy.
It's because there's no emotion attached.
And he trusts me. Not like Alan.
Oh, Alan.
The bitch! Not in the empowering way.
The bastard.
Shit, man. Hello, this is Bea, the hot, sexy-ass princess speaking. I'm so sorry. I'm still thinking about my ex. How about I hang up so you can call me back? Okay. Thunderstorm. Oh! He's being electrocuted.
Cognitive restructuring and positive visualization. You listened to my seminar.
I listened to all your seminars. Do you think they're going to call back?
Why not? They're probably just calling you at the same time as someone else. Locking them up.
You're probably right.
I'm proud of you.
For what?
The improvisation, the oral cues leading to you reading into the sexual neurosis of the client calling. The psychology behind it is fascinating. Nothing I can accomplish. I struggle to have a normal conversation with anyone.
What is normal? And who cares about being normal? Be better than normal. Be abnormal. Not too long, my darling. Besides, you talk to tens of doctorate students on a monthly basis.
That's talking at them, not with them. I'm boring. I'm boring.
You're underestimating yourself, and it's a damn crime. Your vibrancy lies just beneath the surface, my dear. How about you take the next call? Or we can do it together. Lucky bastard, we'll get a 2-for-1.
I don't know.
Only if you want to.
Maybe later. I'd love to finish my chapter.
It's affirmative, gorgeous. I'll try to be quieter.
There's no need.
Okay, good. Hi there, stud. Let me make your wireless fantasies possible. We can do anything. Anything, darling. The world's our little bitch tonight, and so am I, so what is it you want me to do? Excuse me? You want me to... with a whisk? And where is that whisk supposed to... Oh no, sir! I do not consider myself a culinary professional, but I know enough to say that whisks do not go there! No! Boy, I self-identify as a freak, but... you don't need a phone sex operator. You need to step away from your baking supplies now. If you'd like me to refer you to a support line, you can telepay me or leave your bank account number. And they're gone. So
talking about. I googled it up while you were trying to come up with lucrative money-making schemes.
My sexy side hustle, yes, go on.
Well, some people get aroused by the thought of giving up total control. That means bank accounts.
Busy. Conrad, lovely, will you come and join me? Lovely love, my Conrad. Why, oh why, haven't we beautiful dummies done this before?
It's just been a popular kink for straight men from all the information I've gathered.
Why?
I don't know. Maybe the male...
Yeah, I refuse to believe that. It should be an inclusive kink for everybody. It's a gold mine. And I'm not just trying to scam them. Or I am. If that's what they want.
Give me your bank account number and password, and I will pretend to enjoy simulating sex with you.
Conrad. Foreplay, drama, specifics to keep them hooked.
But that is not efficient.
Lovely. Here, darling, I'll show you. Hello, good sir. And blessed evening to you, sir. Have you heard the good word of the house? They didn't let me finish. I was going to say my penis, and they didn't let me finish.
How very impolite.
No.
It's just about to get good.
Love, am I dull? Am I not sexy enough?
Why would you ask that?
I'm fishing.
For fishing?
For compliments.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Of course, my dear, you are the essence of whimsy and personification of sexual desire.
I know. I'm lucky enough to have your support and even an audience at my disposal.
I think you should apologize to the stage manager.
What for?
For spraining her tailbone with your head.
It's not my fault she's a bigot. There's no market for your kind of drag. Your kind of drag, my ass. I work twice as hard as everyone else there. Just because I refuse to stuff my bra full of chicken doesn't mean it's not drag.
It was unfair, yes, but you enjoyed your job as a performer, am I correct?
I don't want to go crawling back. It just makes me seem weak. Everybody asks me, B, how is it you deal with all the ignorance you come across in the world? And my sweet audience, I have come across many bigots, most of which are in my own family. I mean, do you think this goes over well at Thanksgiving dinner? Not in the least. No, perhaps I'm not the best person to come to on matters of de-escalation. Like that one Thanksgiving, I thrust my fist at the turkey's ass as my grandmother was debating me on my own homosexuality.
Or that same Thanksgiving when your stepfather insinuated you had AIDS and you stabbed a fork into your bicep and chased him around the room with your bleeding arm.
Yes, that one. For every twat waffle in the world, there's someone who thinks you're more captivating and logifying than Dolly Parton's titties. See, this world produces a lot of weirdos. You'll find your weirdos and you'll find out what kind of weirdo you want to be. So, stay away from turkey anal and forks, unless the dramatic action truly calls for it, my sweet audience. Okay, don't burn down anyone's house or chase anyone around the table with a fork in your arm. I'm saying that explicitly because there are better ways to deal with your problems, and I'm still working on myself. My words instead of ramming my head at the manager's ass. Are you all happy now? Am I growing and changing as an individual to outgrow my very few and seldom flaws? Look at us. Me apologizing. You talking dirty to phone weirdos. This is character development right here.
Hello. I am a very sexy man. I would like to very specifically touch my penis to your penis. It's the learning.
Garlic bread makes you fat.
We could work through the destructive flaws and encourage the quirks that I fell in love with.
You said you loved me. That's so embarrassing for you.
I'm joking, lover boy. Let's go to bed.
Sorry, I'd invite you all, but there's so little room. Just space for me and my comrade.
Oh, should we leave them with like a moral or something?
No, please don't learn anything from us.
Anything that you have learned from this stage play should not be taken as representative or affiliated with the majority of queer individuals. In the least bit. At all.
Hallelujah, my gorgeous audience. Be your wonderful selves, but remember, there can and only should be one bee, lest the time-space continuum be fucked.
I still don't know what Twonky is referring to.
Don't look it up.